Welcome, everyone. Thank you for being here. I'm just going to give a little bit of background as to how this whole initiative came to be. My name is Rahman Jamaal, currently the National Executive Director for Hip Hop Congress, which is one of the partner organizations for H2E2. I joined Hip Hop Congress as a student in college back in the early 2000s. Hip Hop Congress was a kind of a phenomenon that started off as an artist vision that later connected with students from another part of the state that were inspired to bring artists to campus and spread awareness on local issues. And they merged to form the current nonprofit. One of the amazing things about it is that we would hold these national conferences in a different city across the country each year. We held 9 of them. In 2004, our conference was in St. Louis, Missouri. And Martha was our keynote speaker. The initiative or the theme of that conference was hip hop and education. And so a lot of us, myself included, went back to our respective local communities and began exploring this idea of how artists can become teachers and create their own curriculums. The goal has been to expand that opportunity for other individuals who are creative artists, but also have that community mind and want to give back, and creating a pipeline for student to career. Fast forward almost 20 years, I meet Allison. And Allison was working in the Department of Education, and then she got this great new position as the head of AME. And she was in the position to actually take all of this groundwork and foundation that had been being laid over a decade, and really plug it into the Department of Education. And being an advocate of this whole movement and initiative, bringing Martha, Allison, and then Sebastien, who I knew back when I was in college, when I was still that student, also was a key factor because he had been teaching under a CTE credential, a hip hop curriculum in high school. So, he was kind of proof that hip hop can be taught through a credentialing system. And so these four elements allowed us to really put into concrete vision something that we're all gathered here today to contribute to learn from each other, and to really figure out the best way to make this a real thing for our students in the future. While we have the speakers that we have scheduled today to speak, we don't represent the fullness of this initiative. Everybody that's here represents a piece of the puzzle, and this is just the first step in getting everybody up to speed, and then talking about how we can coordinate all of that so that we can really revolutionize the state of education and strategize on this level. So I'm really, really glad that everybody's here today. Like I said, this is being recorded, so this is also documentation and archiving of history. So right now I want to introduce Allison, who is our champion in the California Department of Education, and she'll introduce her role in supporting this grant program that is H2E2, Hip Hop Education and Equity.
Hi, everyone, and thank you for being here. So I actually started as a classroom teacher. I taught English and dance for 15 years, and in my teaching, I always felt it essential to bring in experts who have lived experience to help supplement and inform my teaching. And so my dance program was really founded on this partnership idea where you bring in teaching artists to teach all the foundations. And in hip hop specifically, as a dance educator, I wanted to make sure that it was a true partnership between the experts and myself, who has limited expertise in certain areas. And I realized that. And so philosophically, I was really behind this initiative from the beginning. As Rahman mentioned, Sebastien Elkouby, who will be talking today, he really was living proof that hip-hop education can be a way to bring in culturally responsive and sustaining pedagogy into inner-city youth, engage them in a career pathway. And so when I moved from the public education classroom setting to the California Department of Education, my new task was to support all arts, media, and entertainment career tech ed programs, but also to support secondary arts in the state of California. And this initiative was really important to me as kind of the first thing that I put my energy behind at the department, because it aligned with the governor's Diverse Teacher Workforce Initiative. It aligned with my superintendent, Tony Thurman's initiatives around building more opportunities for schools in the space of culturally responsive pedagogy. And it aligned with my partners in the Educator Excellences Division in building a teacher workforce as well. So, anyways, we were able to get our first grant approved for this program, and this is a grant that supported a teacher pipeline program where industry professionals who were interested in careers in teaching could work to get their CTE credential and be coached on all of the strategies for teaching hip-hop education in arts, media, and entertainment. And those of you who know, the CTE credential is kind of an alternative credential path for industry professionals who want to go into education and doesn't require the same four-year degree and testing and additional credential experience. It allows you to transfer your industry experience into teaching expertise, but what's missing is really that coaching. And so thanks to Sebastien and View Park Prep, we launched our first pilot program with a cohort that he'll talk about a little later of, I think, between 6 and 10 individuals who are wanting to transition from being industry professionals to classroom teachers. And so that program was a pilot program in a year that was unlike any other. And so we are continuing to do work in that space. But this year we really wanted to expand opportunities to more schools. And so our grant program doubled from a small $60,000 mini grant to a $120,000 grant. And we've brought on two more school programs to really look at how to provide training and mentoring and hip-hop pedagogy for new and existing arts, media, and entertainment teachers, but also to build model arts, media, and entertainment hip-hop programs for students. And some of the goals and outcomes of this new grant are to establish and expand hip-hop-focused arts, media, and entertainment programs in the fields of multimedia and audio production, professional music, professional dance, film and video production, and visual and commercial arts. Also to provide mentoring and coaching opportunities for new and existing credential candidates and teachers in the grant recipient's region, and to design and post publicly hip-hop focused program materials and curriculum. And also finally, as Rahman mentioned, to integrate formal student leadership and work-based learning opportunities through hip-hop partner organizations. So we really want to build a program that brings together partners, help 501c3 and other hip-hop education businesses in partnership with public education to build more opportunities for students. And one of the individuals that is kind of groundbreaking in her work in this space is Martha Diaz. And I'm very fortunate to have her as a thought partner and a friend and colleague in all of this work. As the founder of the Hip Hop Education Center, she's been in this game for a very long time. Her recent endeavor, Hip Hop CU in Hip Hop CommUniversity, is really a way to pull all these resources into one place and allow schools to interface with true, authentic hip hop professionals. So without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to Martha to introduce the rest of the day and our guest speaker.
Thank you, Allison. You're wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. All right. I am so happy that this is happening. This has been, 20 years in the making. I started out in 2001. Trying to figure out how we can integrate hip hop in schools. And it finally, it took a person like Allison to really make this happen with this initiative. Although we've been doing this work all along, some of the people that you're going to hear and see their presentations, you're going to see that this isn't anything new. We've been doing this for a long time and we've been documenting it. There are research papers about the work. We have think tanks that we've been hosting for a decade now. And so for us to launch this initiative in California, it is definitely going to be the model for other states to implement, but also get behind. Like, we are one universe, right? That's why I named Hip Hop CommUniversity. It's the community and the university coming together to provide different pathways to education. And so for us, this means that the community is involved, that the pioneers of hip hop are involved, that teaching artists can collaborate, that it's not just a state initiative, it is a international effort where we could connect students from California to students in New York, to students in Germany, to students in South Africa. That's our plan. We want to expand and share the power of hip hop education everywhere. And so someone who has been the ambassador, someone who has been who exemplifies this vision is our keynote speaker. And I will introduce him quickly. His name is Jamaal Mims. He is an African-American bilingual Chinese rapper. He's a multimedia artist and, above all, a revolutionary. Yes, I'll let him say the rest because he is just an amazing person. We had to have him open up this conference because of his work and his dedication. So without further ado, please give it up to Jamaal Mims.